Howdy, folks. Live from Big Top Chautauqua, welcome to another episode of Tent Show Radio. I can't believe another year's gone around. Is that a Big Top? I see they're lying on the ground. Ballyhoo. Ah, ballyhoo. Funding support for Tent Show Radio is provided by Travel Wisconsin. Smile a little wider with a Wisconsin getaway. Find mouth-watering dining ideas, must-see attractions, and endless accommodations at TravelWisconsin.com or on our app for iPhone and Android. And by Norsky Nook, a unique gift shop setting offering pies made from scratch, Norwegian and American meals, or just coffee and conversation, NorskyNook.com. And now here's your host of Tent Show Radio, best-selling author, humorist, singer-songwriter, and part-time pig farmer, Michael Perry.
Thank you, Phil, and howdy, Tent Show folks. Oh, it's great to be way up north here. Under the beautiful blue and pearl gray canvas, this fine stout tent at the foot of Mount Ashwa Bay, overlooking the ancient waters surrounding the Apostle Islands and just one sail full of breeze away from Shawamigan Bay. The performance you're about to hear is one in a long, long tradition of singing, dancing, and storytelling performed live and in person beneath this beautiful tent. We keep her pitched from June until the autumn moons, and we'd be most grateful if you choose to join us. You'll find a complete schedule at bigtop.org. We hope you join us, and if you do, when the first note rises from the stage, we think you'll understand why patrons and performers alike love to say, Big Top Chautauqua. It's the Carnegie Hall of Tent Shows. Tonight on Tent Show Radio, two-time Country Music Association Female Vocalist of the Year, Kathy Mattea. Ladies and gentlemen of the canvas, we're thrilled to have Kathy Mattea in the tent tonight. It's been a while, and we've missed her. And I mean that in the straight-up, non-guilt-loaded way, not in the, say, you weren't in church last Sunday, we missed you sort of way. No, we just missed hearing her gorgeous songs about love and loss and roses and truckers and rivers and roads and whatever else she chooses to sing about. Some folks are known as great songwriters. Kathy Mattea is known as a great song catcher. Her finest abilities lie in the interpretation of songs, no matter the writer. Although she's got some fine taste there as well, having hit the charts with songs written by Nancy Griffith and Gillian Welch and the like. Folks, she'll fill this tent with heart and harmony, and we just couldn't be happier to have her back. From the hills of West Virginia to the hills of Wisconsin's own Bayfield County, please welcome Kathy Mattea.
This highway's a wreck. lonesome. Don't care where I lay my head down. My Virginia boy died brokenhearted. My sweet mountain darling is gone. It's a far cry from here to Virginia, but I'd crawl every inch of that ground. My teardrops fall like rain on the roof of that Blue Ridge home where I'm bound. Yeah, my teardrops fall like rain on the roof of that Blue Ridge home. Do you feel a kindred spirit to the sound of pouring rain? Does your heart start to yearning when you hear a distant train? If you'd like to take that train and ride to someone left behind, you don't need the wind to tell you you're on lonesome standard time. Do you sit alone and think about an old love from the past? Do you feel a bit more empty every time you raise your glass? The rim of your man's kisses sends a shiver up your spine. You don't need a watch to tell you you're on lonesome standard time. When you hear them old sad songs, do you hang on every word? Do you swear kind it's the sweetest sound on earth? If you shudder at the music of a hoot owl in the pine, you're on lonesome standard time. There's a bigger clock ticking, it crosses every zone. The first time your old heart broke was the time you turned it on. You don't ever need a winding, as if it works like mine. Well, there ain't no doubt about it, you're on a lonesome standard time. Oh, when you hear them old sad songs, do you hang on? Do you swear crying fiddle has the sweetest sound on earth? If you should have the music of a hoot owl in the pines, you're on lonesome standard time. Well, if you should have the music of a hoot owl in the pines, you're on lonesome some standard time.
Well, you know, it's been 15 years since I've been here, and you wouldn't want to rush these things, you know? You don't want to wear out your welcome in a place that you grow to love. And, gosh, I've been through about 4 or 5 hairstyles since then. And several hair colors, actually, as well. And it's just... I'm sorry? No, not husbands. I have to tell you, I'm still married to the same guy I was married to last time I was here. Thank you. And happy about that. He's from my husband, just so you know. He understands your people, even though the languages are very close, but not exactly the same. My husband's from Minnesota. Yes. Oh, hey, yeah, you know, it's more about the walleye than the cheese over there and the tuna hot dish. But, well, it's great to be back. And I have to tell you, the drive up here was just stunning. And just all the sailboats out and the people, like, everybody's, you know, tucked down every little side road you can see are campers and families. And it's just, it's lovely to be back. And I have to tell you, they fed us all local food. And it was fantastic meal, which always makes the guys play better. That and a little beer at the end of the night, kind of like a horse to the barn, you know, it'll be great. So anyway, it's wonderful to be back with you. And that opening song is a song off my latest record. And the second one is an older song of mine that I did when I was really young, written by my friend Larry Cordell. And that's sort of what we want to do tonight. We want to maybe hit some songs you haven't heard and maybe some songs you haven't heard in a long time. So this is an old tune of mine that I did a long time ago. And someone requested it not too long ago, and I realized I kind of missed it. Friends I could count on, I could count on one hand, with a leftover finger or two. I took them for granted, let them all slip away. Now where they are, I wish I And I guess we never learn. We go through life parched and empty, standing knee deep in a river and dying of thirst. Sometimes I remember sweethearts I've known. Some I've forgotten, I suppose. One or two still linger. Oh, and I wonder now why I ever let them go. They roll by just like water, and I guess we never learn. We go through life parched and empty, standing knee deep in a river and die in a thirst. Just look the other way. They roll by just like water, and I guess we never learn. We go through life
And I guess we never learn. We go through life parched and empty, standing knee deep in a river, and die in a
Appalachian music in the last few years, and it's kind of ironic because I grew up in West Virginia, you know, and this stuff was all around me when I was growing up, and I got so into music at such a young age, but I was like a sponge, you know. I would learn anything, you know, the latest rock and roll song, somebody would teach me, I don't care, I got an acoustic guitar, I don't care. Any song that someone would teach me, I would learn, but there was no one in my world that knew this kind of music, so it's kind of like going back and picking up a piece in your jigsaw puzzle that was missing all along and you didn't realize it. So it's been really, really fun. And there's a... There's a lot of banjo on this album, and so I sort of picked it up and started messing around with it again after many, many years, and quickly realized why moonshine and banjos are from the same part of the country. I remember the year that my granddad died, gone, gonna rise again. They dug his grave on the mountainside, gone, gonna rise again. I was too young to understand the way he felt about the land, but you could read his history in his hands, gone, gonna rise again. Well, it's corn in the crib and apples in the bin, gone, gonna rise again. It's ham in the smokehouse and cotton in the gin, gone, gonna rise again. It's cows in the barn and hogs in the lot, you know we never had a lot. But he worked like the devil for the living he got, gone, gonna rise again. Apple trees on the mountainside, gone, gonna rise again. He planted the seeds just before he died, gone, gonna rise again. I guess he knew that he'd never see red fruit hanging from the tree, but he planted the seeds for his children and me, gone, gonna rise again. High on the ridge above the farm, gone, gonna rise again. I think of my people that have gone on, gone, gonna rise again. Like a tree that grows in the mountain ground, storms of life have cut them down. But the dew it springs from the roots in the ground, gone, gonna rise again, gone, gonna rise again, gone. Gonna rise again. By my friend Cy Khan, and Cy wrote that a long time ago about a piece of land that his family, his grandfather owned in western Pennsylvania in the mountains there, and sort of about how generation after generation will live on the same piece of land and sort of know it so that this, like a mountain, will be like a member of the family back home. So we drove... started noticing the iron signs, the iron mining signs up here, and I was like, oh yeah, we're in mining country too. It's just a little bit of a different animal up here. And when I went to make this album, I had finished a record called Coal, and it was all about coal mining. And it happened to me after a disaster, a big mine disaster back in West Virginia, and I was feeling all of this emotion that I didn't understand. And through the encouragement of a friend, decided to get that emotion out of me by going back and recording songs about coal mining and sort of pouring all of this emotion into this record. And it just changed my life, really. It made me understand the songs that I've been singing for many years in a whole different way, because a lot of these songs are the roots of all that music. So when I went to make the next album, I wanted to keep kind of plumbing this. You know, it's like finding a treasure trove of music that you didn't know about before. But, you know, there's all kinds of songs on this record, but you can't sing about Appalachia without singing about coal mining somewhere along the line. So this is a song written by my friend Larry Cordell, who's from East Kentucky. He wrote Lonesome Standard Time years ago and has written all kinds of hit songs for lots of people. But he has buddies back in East Kentucky who have these kinds of conversations. And I think the thing I love about this song is I think we're quickly losing the ability to have civil discourse in our culture when we disagree. And Larry's provided civil discourse in a 3-minute song, which I think is pretty freaking amazing. So. I'm from West by God, Virginia, and the high Kentucky hills. I'm dirty, but I'm honest. I pay a poor man's bills. I'm prosperity. I'm a scoundrel and a saint. I'm loved, reviled, misunderstood. I'm hope in a hopeless place. Hello, my name is Cole, and around here I'm the king. Some say I'm a savior, some say death is what I bring. Well, I've broke miners' backs and hearts, and I've wrestled for their souls. Let me introduce myself. Hello, my name is Cole. Some men call me black gold. You might have heard. Breath is kerosene. Well, you might think I'm out of date if I'm out of style and old. Then why do men still dig me all around the globe? Hello, my name is Cole, and around here I'm the queen. Some say I'm cheap and easy, oh, but they still bow to me. Be careful, I'll break up your home, and I'll steal away your soul. It's dangerous to lust for me. Hello, my name is Cole. They curse me now for what I am, but not that long ago. They sang my praises everywhere. Hello, my name is Cole.
You are listening to Tent Show Radio.
Welcome back to Tent Show Radio, folks, from the backstage dressing room with the one lonely little light bulb burning. Sometimes if you spend a warm Wisconsin evening inside a welcoming canvas tent, listening to fresh, live music, you can forget that the sight of a tire swing hanging dead still at 20 below is an unexpected heart whomper that will, in fact, freeze you in your tracks. Or at least it did me. We were in the middle of a near-record-deep freeze stretch, It was high noon, and I had made a shirt-sleeves dash for the house to prospect the refrigerator for leftovers. I'd been working in a cozy little room above the garage, and that first draft of outside air even tasted cold. Something to drink rather than inhale. Flows to the lungs like neutral spirits, with trace notes of rainwater and ozone. The sun had the countryside lit up Arctic stark, the type of merciless shine that takes the breath from warm-born citizens who associate bright sun with vacation and beach blankets. There it is, blazing in the heavens, and yet we scuttle along with our shoulders hunched against the cold as if bracing for a blow. But then I saw that tire swing, and I came to a stop. There was something powerful in the frozen motionlessness of it. The lower third of the rubber circle was fixed in the snow, and the bristly rope was drawn straight as a plumb bob to the limb above. The swing hangs from a giant white pine that, despite the mutilations of windstorms and time, still manages stateliness as it anchors the yard. Even as I stood in the snow-banked trough of the sidewalk, it didn't take much to summon the sound of laughing children running laps around the bulwark trunk as they waited to take their turn on the tire, dodging as a playmate swung through them in a giggling arc. My brothers helped me hang the swing during a weekend get-together shortly after we moved to the farm. I steadied the stepladder for John, who's better at knots, while Jed hoisted and held the tire at just the right height. Then I drilled holes in the dependent half of the tire so the mosquito water could drain, and taped up the lower 3 feet of the rope like the handle of a baseball bat to protect small hands from burn or blister. All the while we worked, my elder daughter pogoed around us, bouncing her way through the impossible weight. When I finally lifted her aboard and sent her gently spinning, her laughter twirled through the air. Today that daughter is a teenager and taller than I. And right there is what threw the brakes on my lunchtime sprint. The sight of the snowbound swing flashbacked me straight to the day we hung it, and while the distance from here to there, from now to then, is in theory a line straight as that ruler of a rope, it felt dramatically shorter and far more convolute. Beyond the swing, the granary was capped with snow a foot deep. The empty corn crib stood bare-ribbed against the back 40. Down by the barnyard, the blackberry canes arced up, over and back into the snow like barbed wire croquet hoops, abandoned after autumn's final game. And from the stripped limbs of a back valley maple came the phoebe of an unseen chickadee. The air, as it always is at these temperatures, was infused with mortality. Everything was still, and nothing more so than that swing, a pendulum marking time without motion. The thing about 20 Below is it disrespects reflection and introspection. In short, overthinking leads to frostbite. I entered the house, made a sandwich, and ate it, an act of existential bravery that precipitated an immediate diffusion of mortality's tincture. Then I scuttled back to the garage, although not before stopping in the same spot for one more look. On sun-bright winter days, the sky can be so blue and the pine needles so green that if you tip your head back until the colors align just so, you can convince yourself it is summer, which we trust is coming. And then we can go to the Big Top and listen to music. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, Kathy Mattea.
I was a curly-headed baby. My daddy set me down on his knee. He said, go to school and get your letters. Don't you be a dirty coal miner like me. I was born and raised at the mouth of the Highland Holler. Old cars rumbled past my door. Stand in a rusty row all empty, 'cause the elder don't stop here anymore. Well, I used to think my daddy was a black man, script enough to buy the company store. Now he goes to town with empty pockets and his face is white as February snow. Oh, I was born and raised at the mouth of the Highland Holler. Old cars rumble past my door. Now they stand in Rusty Row all empty, 'cause the evidence don't stop here anymore. Roar. Oh God, I wish the grass would turn to money and those greenbacks fill my pockets up once more. Oh, I was born and raised at the mouth of the Highland Holler. Old cars rolled and rumbled past my door. Now they stand in a Rusty Row all empty, 'cause the evidence don't stop here anymore. Last night I dreamed I went down to the coal yard to draw my pay like I had done before. But them kudzu vines are covering all the windows, and there were leaves and grass growing right up through the floor. Oh, I was born and raised at the mouth of the Highland Holler. Cars rumble past my door. Now they stand in a Rusty Row all empty, 'cause the evidence don't stop here anymore.
People over the years. Probably the most famous version is Johnny Cash's version. And, it's about the Louisville and Nashville Railroad. And I got to ask Jean about it. She said when the coal mine shut down in Viper, they used to send the train up, you know, to get the coal out. And that happened all day, every day. But a couple of times a day, they'd send a little spur of the passenger train up there. And that's how people got into town to do their shopping. And when the mine shut down, they also quit running the little passenger trains. So for a lot of people, for their whole life, that's the way they had gotten into town. So they were stranded in a completely new way. The ripples of the closing of the mine sort of went in all kinds of unexpected directions. Charlie's got a gold watch. Don't seem like a whole lot. After 30 years of driving up and down the interstate. Yeah, but Charlie's had a good life, and Charlie's got a good wife. And after tonight, she'll no longer be counting the days. 18 wheels and a dozen roses, 10 more miles on his 4-day run. Then he'll spend the rest of his life with the one that he loves. They'll buy a Winnebago, set out to find America.
They'll do a lot of catching up, a little out of time, with pieces of the old dream. They're gonna light the old flame, doing what they please, leaving every other reason behind. 18 wheels and a dozen roses, 10 more miles on its 4-day run, a few more songs from the all-night radio, then he'll spend
love. All right, you want to sing one with us? Here we go. 18 wheels and a dozen roses, 10 more on his 4-day run, a few more songs from the all-night radio, then he'll spend the rest of his life with the one that he loves. Ooh, they all sound good. Just sound good under the big tent, friends. You Wisconsiner rights, you Wisconsinines, you Cheeserators. Good singing, very good singing. And I'm thinking, you know, it's kind of neat to see what it sounds like in a tent when we all raise our voices. But I saw a few people down front who aren't even bothering to move their lips to make me feel better. And you are the people I'm speaking to. Yes, not just the people in the front, but the people all the way back who may not be actually giving this moment their all. And I just want to say I have this theory about the sing-along portion of our show. You know, when we're kids, we sing all the time. Everybody's born to sing, you know. I really think it's our birthright. And if you watch little kids, they just sing wide open. They don't care. And then somewhere along the line, they get divided into two categories. Either people who can sing or people who can not sing. And if you get put into the second category, you close your mouth and you never sing again. And someone robs you of something that I think is a crime. So, yeah. My mother was one of those people. She was completely tone deaf. That's what they called it. She couldn't carry a tune. And she was asked at one point not to sing. So she didn't sing. And then later in her life, she got Alzheimer's. And she forgot that she couldn't sing. So she sang all the time. So that's what I'm talking about. This is the joyful noise portion of the show, the birthright of the good and bad singers raising their voices together in the name of singing itself. Can I hear an amen? Yeah. All right, let me hear you sing. 18 wheels and a dozen roses, 10 more miles on his 4-day run, a few more songs. Then he'll spend the rest of his life with the one that he... Okay, one without the band. 18 wheels and a dozen roses. Oh, man. 10 more miles on his 4-day run. You sound beautiful. A few more songs from the all-night radio. Then he'll spend the rest of his life with the one that he loves. That was a thing of beauty! Oh, I'll do it. I'll do it. I'll do it. I'll do it right now. So. All right, you can sing on this one too if you want.
Save me, Bill.
Now, Mr. Smith had an Oldsmobile. baby blue with wire wheels. I took her home the day that she was advertised. He said she leaped when it won't rain. It sounded like an airplane, but I knew she was a jewel in disguise. She had a 455 rocket, the biggest block alive. I couldn't hardly wait just to take my turn. She was made for the straight ways. She grew up hate Chevrolets. She's a rocket. She was made to burn. Well, whose junk pile piece of Chevelle is this? Did you boys come here to race or just kiss?
Now don't you wanna know what I got?
Like she's missing, but buddy, she can teach you a lesson. It's just a quarter mile, and I'll smoke you good in my 455 rocket, the kind of police drive. I couldn't hardly wait just to take that turn. She was made. Ways. She grew up hate Chevrolets. She's a rocket. She was made to burn.
David Spiker back there on the upright bass. And on fiddle and mandolin over here, this is Eamon O'Rourke. And on lead guitar and bouzouki, this is Bill Cooley. Hit the curve and began to sail. Took out most of the safety rail. Even the cop asked me, "Man, what you have in that thing?" Well, I had a 455 rocket, the very kind you drive. You wanna watch yourself when you take that turn. She was made for the straight ways. She grew up hate Chevrolets. She's a rocket. She was made to burn.
walk down the hall where the wounds used to stand. Concrete at my feet, brick walls at every hand. And over my head, steel girders so strong, where I first felt the spell of the wood thrush's song. Now the wood thrush has vanished, seeking the place that's not felt the crush of man's embrace. The steep woods are gone now, and oh, how I long to again feel the spell of the wood thrush's song. Just a few years ago, the poplar leaves shivered when the breezes did blow. Now the deep hum of engines drowns the soft sigh of the wind in the leaves of the few trees nearby. Now the wood thrush has vanished, seeking the place that's not felt the crush of man's embrace. The steep woods are gone now, and oh, how I long to again feel the spell of the wood thrush's song. Thrush refrain. Now the wood thrush has vanished, seeking the place that's not felt the crush of man's embrace. Steep woods are gone now, and oh, how I long to again feel the spell of the wood thrush's song. Steep woods are gone now, and oh, how I long to again feel the spell of the wood thrush's song.
Top of Wisconsin, Tent Show Radio is a production of the nonprofit Lake Superior Big Top Chautauqua, the summer home of Tent Show Radio. Funding support for Tent Show Radio is provided by Travel Wisconsin. Smile a little wider with a Wisconsin getaway. Find mouth-watering dining ideas, must-see attractions, and endless accommodations at travelwisconsin.com or on our app for iPhone and Android. And we're brought to you by the Bayfield Chamber and Visitor Bureau, Bayfield, Wisconsin. Offering sailing and kayaking among 22 pristine islands, gourmet restaurants, art galleries, and historic lodging. Information online at bayfield.org. And we're brought to you by the Bayfield Inn, located on the shoreline of Lake Superior, proudly hosting Bayfield's visitors for nearly 100 years. Rooftop deck bar and events for all occasions, online at thebayfieldinn.com. Tune in next time, on your radio or online. Station locations, Big Top Summer Show schedule, online ticketing, and touring schedule of the Blue Canvas Orchestra at bigtop.org or by calling 1-888-BIG-TENT. Or stay in touch with us on Facebook at facebook.com/BigBlueTent. Tent Show Radio is produced by Tom Fabjans, Michael Perry, Jamie Hansen, and yours truly, Philip Anich.
Kathy Mattea, thank you, Kathy. Thank you for coming back to the tent. Wonderful to have you back. Well, folks, that's our show for tonight. Whether you join us in the tent or join us in the air, whether you beam us or stream us, we're as grateful as a guy who's all warm and toasty and has a sandwich. Remember, the Big Top is open all summer long and into autumn and has been for going on 3 decades now. We'd love it if you came up and or over for a show. And if you're traveling by World Wide Web, I'd be grateful if you dropped by to visit me, your grateful Tent Show radio host, at sneezingcow.com. Yep, just the way it sounds. I'm going to head on back home now and listen for chickadees. Drive careful. If you can't drive careful, watch out for the other guy. We'll see you next time, and remember, where I come from and here at Tent Show Radio, nobody ever says goodbye. They just say, well, I suppose.
Tent Show Radio will be on the road in 2014. We'll be performing at the Door Community Auditorium in Fish Creek, Wisconsin, April 25th, and at the Richland Center Auditorium in Richland Center, Wisconsin, April 26th, and at the State Theater in Eau Claire, Wisconsin, May 9th, and at the Capitol Theater in Madison, Wisconsin, May 10th, and at the Grand Theater in Wausau, Wisconsin, May 15th, and at the Fox Cities Performing Arts Center in Appleton, Wisconsin, May 16th. Featuring Tent Show Radio host Michael Perry, the Blue Canvas Orchestra, and special musical guests, all live and in person. Ticket information available at TentShowRadio.com.